Good morning, everybody. This is Nobody Man, and this is the day after Halloween, and I decided to try doing this whole Let's Play thing by myself, starting with Star Wars The Force Unleashed. This game has been around since 2008, and I originally played it on the Xbox 360, and it's a pretty good game. It certainly has its flaws, but I remember it fondly. You know, and with all the Star Wars stuff going on right now, you know, with the new movie coming out in just a couple weeks, I decided I want to play this game again on the PC, because, you know, obviously, the PC version is the best version, right? Yeah, not so much. We'll get into that as we play. But first, let me go ahead and start a new game. This is the Ultimate Sith Edition, so I got all the DLC things. And some of these are pretty cool. The Hoth one and the Tatooine one take place after a certain ending of the game, because there are two endings. And I think the Jedi Temple one is supposed to take place during the middle of the main campaign. But we're just going to go ahead and do the main campaign. I'll play on Sith Warrior, which is normal, I guess. So, anyway, here we go. I'll keep quiet for this movie. And I'll see you guys on the other side.
We were ambushed upon arrival, but I have the situation well in...
I have no interest in your feelings, Commander. I'm here on a mission of my own.
And we're back. Interesting video. They seem to really have gotten the character of Darth Vader down in so much as the fact that he gives absolutely zero shits about anybody other than himself and his mission. So anyway, here we go. This is about as fast as he goes, because, like I said, Darth Vader really doesn't give a shit. So if he wants to, you know, walk at a leisurely pace, who's going to tell him no? You? I didn't think so. Anyway, he just kind of deflects shots and pushes them out of the way. You know, sometimes they'll hit people. And now I'm getting hit. Here we go. This is the big thing about the game, is the Force powers. Because this really showed a side of the Force that we never really got to see in any of the movies, in so much that in the right hands, you're basically a god. Or at least, as far as this game's concerned. Anyway, apologies to Peter Mayhew, by the way. I'm sure he's probably very insulted at me killing all of these Wookiees. Oh, yeah. Like I said, it's about as fast as he goes, but if I wanted to, I can jump around like an idiot like this and actually get places. But Vader's a little too dignified for that. So yeah, I can pick up people, I can pick up objects, I can fling them way out into space. And watch them ragdoll, which is pretty humorous. Yeah, the big draw for this game at the time is that the story was really... people were really, really excited for the story about this game because we were going to learn about Darth Vader's secret apprentice, who we're going to meet in just a couple minutes. But at the time, you know, around the same time that this game came out, the Clone Wars movie came out, and I heard a lot of people say that they wish this was made into the movie and the Clone Wars movie was made into the game, because I'm not too experienced with the Clone Wars cartoon. I've seen a few episodes, and it's pretty good, but apparently the movie's not that great. So, what do you do? Another interesting tidbit is that Darth Vader himself in this game is voiced by the actor that plays Chad Vader in a web show, you know, called Chad Vader. And Chad Vader is Darth Vader's little brother who works as an assistant manager at a supermarket. You know, and hilarity ensues. So I like that they had a little nod to the show by having this guy come in and actually play Darth Vader for real instead of just kind of making fun of him. Oh, and of course, being Darth Vader, I can do whatever I want to stormtroopers. Because I'm a jerk that way. And no one's gonna stop me. Yeah. It's fun watching people fly around. So, I played this not too long ago on my Xbox 360, and my now fiancé, you know, at the time she was just my girlfriend, she was watching me play, and she's more of a Star Trek fan than a Star Wars fan, but she really, really loves the Wookiees, so watching me running around killing all of these Wookiees, she's just like, I don't like this game, what are you doing? Stop killing the Wookiees, it's terrible. And I'm like, sorry, dark side, I don't care. Yeah, no. It'll be more fun when I play. Don't let go, Jack! I guess he let go, Jack. What are you running for? Don't run. Get back here. Silly. Anyway, what is it? Hadouken? Or is it Kamehameha? Let's just go Hadouken. Hadouken! You know, Darth Vader might be a little bit more efficient if he just picked up the pace, but again, I'm not going to tell that to him. In the Xbox 360 version, there's an achievement for killing your own men as Darth Vader. Like, if you kill a certain amount of them, you'll get an achievement that says, worst assistant manager ever or something like that. You know, again, another reference to Chad Vader. So, yeah. And there's more Wookiees. So, I know a lot of people have been asking me about how I feel about the new Star Wars movie. Because anybody who knows me in real life will tell you that I am a huge Star Wars nerd. And I have been since about first grade. So, people have been asking me, like, oh, what do you think about the new Star Wars movie? You think it's going to suck? And like, dude, I have no idea how good it's going to be, but I can tell you that from the trailers, I cannot be more excited for this movie. It looks great. You know, anything goes as far as the actual movie's concerned, but I'm still super excited to see it. You know, I have tickets and everything. You know, I bought my tickets about an hour after the newest trailer showed up, which is just a couple weeks ago now, you know. Literally within the first hour, I just bought tickets, and what is going on? I didn't do any of this. Wookiees, great fighters, lousy builders. You know, hey, let's build all of our stuff in trees. It'll look really cool, but apparently we use super glue in all of our construction. Well, I guess I'm not going that way. It's It's good to know that the Empire hasn't gotten better pilots or stormtroopers, you know, in this game as they have in the movies. Hurry up. Yeah, another thing to note, Darth Vader's cape never really looked good, even in the Xbox 360 version of the game, so if it does ridiculous things that it shouldn't, you know, that's just kind of how they designed it. Okay, I have another force power here too, I can do this. Oh, maybe not. I can just imagine the Wookiee strategy meeting for this. Like, Darth Vader's on the planet, what do we do? Throw ourselves at him! Surely he'll get bored with killing us. And I can do little force pushes like that, too. Oh, they're like the cops in Payday. They're just like, clog out their guns with our dead. This is a very rubbery tree. Ah, anyway, here's where we need to go. It's right over here. Well, this game takes a couple cues from God of War, especially with the boss battles, and we're gonna see that in just a sec. He's a quick devil, but he's still no match for Vader. You know, one of the big complaints with this game is that the aiming system for all of your attacks is really kind of shoddy. Oh, thank you. Let me use another quick time event for you. See? Like, I missed him. He's like 20 feet away, and I missed him completely. That should not happen. Oh. Copying me, I see. Two can play at that game. Okay, maybe not. Hey! That comes out of my pocket, you jerk. I almost called him a dick, but that's not nice. Buddy, you are starting to piss me off. Anyway, I almost got him. Here we go. There's something I have to tell you. I'm not left-handed either. Ow. 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 I recommend a good chiropractor.
I sense someone far more powerful nearby. Where is your master?
The dark side has clouded your mind. You killed my master years ago.
Then now you will share his fate. A son.
Run!
Vader.
Come with me. More will be here soon. You were weak when I found you. Now your hatred has become your strength. At last, the dark side is your ally. Rise, my apprentice.
What is your will, my master?
Your training is nearly complete. It is time to face your first true test.
The spies have located a Jedi.
Yes, Master Ram Kota. He is attacking a critical Imperial shipyard. Destroy him. Bring me his lightsaber.
I shall leave at once, Master.
The Emperor cannot discover you. Leave no witnesses. Kill everyone aboard, Imperials and Kota's men alike.
As you wish, my Master.
Proxy, you did catch me by surprise. I haven't fought that training program in years. I thought you'd erased it.
I hoped that using an older training module would catch you off guard and allow me to finally kill you. I'm sorry I failed you again.
Well, I'm sure you'll keep trying. Yeah, but do me a favor. Don't ambush me anything.
Proxy.
Yes, why are we whispering?
Shh, who's that?
Ah, yes. Your new pilot has finally arrived, Master. Accessing Imperial records.
Captain Juno Eclipse, born on Korolag, where she became the youngest student ever accepted into the Imperial Academy. Decorated combat pilot with over 100 combat missions, and commanding officer during the bombing of Kalos. Handpicked by Lord Vader to lead his Black Five squadron, but later reassigned to a top secret mission.
Is there a psychological profile in there too?
Actually, yes. But it's restricted. I can tell you she's going to be impossible to reprogram.
Do you know why you're here?
Yes. My orders are clear. And keep your ship running and fly you wherever your missions require.
Did Vader tell you that he killed our last pilot?
No. But I can only assume that he gave Lord Vader good reason to do so. I will not.
Let's hope so. I'm sick of training new pilots. What have you done to my ship?
I've taken the liberty of upgrading the Rogue Shadow sensor array. Now you'll be able to spy on any suspect ships within the entire system. You are one of Vader's spies.
You don't need to know anything about my missions except where I'm going. Now I need to jump to Nar Shaddaa. Can you handle that?
Of course.
God, he could cut the tension with a vibroblade. Anyway, now we finally have our actual main character, Starkiller, who is, yes, Darth Vader's secret apprentice. Now we're going to Nar Shaddaa to kill more people. But first, a bit of training, even though I just played this game and know how to train. Welcome aboard the Rogue Shadow Master. I've recently installed a training room. All these modules are trained to kill you, just like me. Yeah, Proxy's kind of like an HK-47, but light. Yes, I know how to do this. I think it's interesting that they give you the training sequence after you've played as Darth Vader and know how to do all these things. Like, break these random panes of glass. Clearly a good use of your force powers. Excuse me. Anyway. Yeah, I don't think there's a training room that big on this little ship. It's only a model.
Roxy, give me the target.
According to Imperial records, Master Ron Kota was a respected general in the Clone Wars.
You're hunting Jedi.
I bring Darth Vader's enemies to justice. Now so do you.
Master Kota was a military genius, but felt that clone soldiers were unfit for battle. Instead, he relied on his own militia.
So there were no clones in his squad when Order 66 was issued?
And after Order 66, he vanished. Official Imperial records actually claim he's dead.
Why come out of hiding and attack the Empire now?
He wants to be found.
Then we're walking into a trap. How many pilots have you lost before me?
7.
Excellent. Coordinates for Nar Shaddaa are locked. Prepare for lightspeed.
Lock down the command center and get that hologram projector up and running.
Yes, sir.
Tell all squads to fan out and funnel any opposition towards us. Explosive charges on levels 2, 5, and 12, just like we planned.
General Kota.
He's here.
I've finally drawn you out of hiding. Lower the containment field on Hangar 12 and tell the men to get into position.
Yes, General.
I hold my lightsaber backwards because it's cool. Also, I run places! Yeah, let me go ahead and turn on the subtitles if we even have subtitles in this POS PC port. Yes, display subtitles. Thank you. Just make things a little easier. Anyway. I think I maybe got another minute before I should cap this episode. And I'll go ahead and show off some of Starkiller's abilities. Oh, I don't have the super push like Vader does. He just casually picks up a TIE fighter. Oh, and I can hurt myself like an idiot. Ooh, a Sith Holocron. What does it give me? Unlimited energy. This must be for, like, some bonus points to destroy all these TIE fighters. Although I'm not sure why it's rewarding me for destroying TIE fighters when I'm supposed to be working for the Empire and I'm destroying their personal property, but then again, I'm just a gamer with an opinion. What do I know? Shut up, Quickfoot. Anyway, let me open this door, and then I will cap it here and kill the guy behind me who's still shooting. Oh, lots of guys. I wonder what kind of force upgrades I can use now, because I got a talent sphere, which is kind of your, you know, upgrading system for this game. Which one do I want? Well, that's boring. It's also boring. And I guess I'll just go ahead and get one of these, because that's all I can get right now. Anyway, let's take these guys out. Really? So Somehow they made the stormtroopers even less effective than they are in the movie. Did he say bad spot? Or bad spy? Or I don't know. There. Have I killed everybody? I guess so. Anyway, I'll cap this here, and I'll see you guys next time on The Force Unleashed.